Welcome to Volume 3 of Detailed Faces by Patricia Rose. It's for people who enjoy sculpting in polymer clay and want to go a step further in getting better at what they do. The first thing we're going to start with is assessing where the eyes, features, everything go on a bunch of different faces. Like, I'm going to start with a baby and work our way up to a lady, and you're going to understand where the half mark is on a skull. Our eyes are basically the same size as when we're adults as what we're born with. So you're going to see babies when they're small that have large, really large eyes, and the rest of our face just kind of grows into our eyes. So, but if you were to do this by proportion, from the top of the head to the chin, divide that skull in half, and I've done it all the way through. I use this particular graph or chart in one of my other films, but it still applies. And you're going to see that a baby's eyes, face, nose, mouth, everything are in the bottom portion of the skull, the bottom half. And as we get older, this is probably a child about 8 years old, something like that. It's going to have, the eyes are further up. Here's a teenager. If you were to, right at the pupil area, that would be like the half line. And the older we get, it's going to be probably, look at this one up here, to where the top eyelid is at the half mark, or yeah, something like that. To get a really young look on your dolls, you want to try to keep everything at the half line or way below it. We're making pretty lady dolls and children in this film, so you are going to be real conscious of where, at the very beginning of the sculpting, of where you're going to put those half lines. We're going to make X marks the spot, and everything is based off that. We're going to do a little road map, and here it is on this side over here, the same principle, where we have the eyes underneath the half mark. The pink line is the half mark. And if you'll notice also that the face, in another one of my films, I broke it down into, if you were to take a line even after you've got your half mark there, and then wherever you place the eyes, you run an invisible line through the pupil area, and from that down to the bottom of the nose, to the bottom or the middle of the mouth, to the chin. This whole thing is going to be broke into three equal parts on real young children. As the older we get, it's actually going to be a little different. I'm going to turn the page here. You're going to see that, and we haven't talked about this in the other films, you're going to see that the eyes, here's your half line, okay, and eyelids would be, and this is a full-grown woman, the eyelids would be at the half line. The nose is basically half, the bottom of the nose is half the length of the entire face. The other half, this is from where one section to another section, these are equal parts. And everything is based off of the nose. Once you divide that half mark, get it right here, then everything is based off the nose. What you can do is you put a line in where the bottom little divot of the nose is, and you're going to decide basically how wide the nose is by how far apart you want the eyes, and that will be to where the tear ducts. And if you see, there's a line that comes straight down that is right next to the nose wing. It will be right at the tear duct. The further apart these are, the younger the person's going to look. The closer together they are, and most people have closer together, it's not a real sign of intelligence, but well, it's okay, but it's much prettier to have them farther apart. So you want to try that. And the mouth, it goes out to the corners and pretty much to where if the eyes were straight ahead, they're in the iris or the pupil area, and that would be the corners of the mouth. Everything's like a little road map here. And the ears go out to the side. If this was a continuous line, you'll see the top of the ear, the bottom of the nose is basically the bottom of the ear. Now, you know, when you turn your head different ways, it's going to look different ways. So if we were to turn my dolls over from the side here, the nose line would be coming across here, and you'd have a little ear flap that's a little lower. But essentially, it's in the same ballpark, and it's different on different people. So let's go on to the next one. The skull. And the skull, there's a lot to consider when we're doing that. The basics of it is we have these huge cavities where the eyeball is. It's an eye socket. And there is a lot of flesh up in this area around the eye that indents into that area. And then the side temple, you're going to see it when we're sculpting. I'm going to point these things out now, but you're really going to see them thoroughly when I'm actually sculpting the piece. But there's no bone right at the same level. There's a high ridge right here. There's a high ridge across where the cheekbone is. The cheek's a lot higher than you think. There is a big chin area, big forehead, recessed nose bridge, very little, right in this area right here, you're going to have very little fat, unless you're a real young child. It's going to be thinned out, and this is how we end up looking, we have high cheekbones, because there's a lot of flesh that's right in here, and it's the flesh is real close to the bone here, and it sticks out. So that's it on that one. And I'm going to try to sculpt for my first one, Grace Kelly. I don't have a frontal picture of her, but I have a side view. And that's going to really base everything, how she's going to look. She is like the ultimate perfection of a woman. And we all know that. That's why we like the movies. Okay. We have a lot of different pictures of different women, and if you'll notice the difference of the chin, under the chin line, there's more flesh here, neck might be a little too long here. I mean, she had the perfect structure, and there's too much fat right here. The eyes aren't set far enough back on different women. There's more of a dip in this area right here as opposed to that one. There's so many different ones. The younger we want it to look, the more childlike we want it to look. But we're going to try for a reasonable resemblance of her from the side. It may not look like her from the front because I don't have a picture of it. But here's a girl that is, obviously she's grown, but she has a real childlike look. And the reason she has that is because she has her nose closer to her eye level. Just like a child would. A child's bottom half features are divided into 1, 2, 3 lines. So you're going to get 1, 2, 3 sections that are pretty much equal. And a grown woman, once again, a grown woman, the older you want her to look, the nose will be further down, and this whole bottom section will be divided from there to there. Equal parts. So that really puts her nose down a whole lot further than the other one. So I think with those few little notes there, and there's another girl, and that may be the front of our doll that we're going to shoot for, something similar to that. She is a little bit like Grace Kelly in the fact that she doesn't have, you know, deep sunken cheeks here. You're going to see the eye sockets right there, and she's indicated that it's indicated more by a darker tint there. Her nose wings, this is like almost perfected, perfect too, because she's got her nose wings. You can actually draw an invisible line that goes down to the side all the way up to her tear duct and get it. And straight down, you know where that line was on this one, straight down to that point in her mouth. And from her eyes down, if she were looking straight ahead, you would get to the corners of her mouth and it would be equal. So, but she has a younger look, and it's not quite as old as this one was, but if you take a line that went straight across here, well, actually she's got a young look, so her half line would probably be right in that area, and divided to half here, and half here, it's not going to quite be equal. So that means that she is going to be have a younger look. So if you would divide it into threes, her nose will be up here, and her mouth will be here, just where it is. But the nose is a little longer, so you can tell that she's at least 18 years of age. It's okay. And let me see what this one is. Back to the... I think we're done with this. So I'm going to get started sculpting now, and I'm going to start with a round ball of clay like this and square off the jawline in the front. And that's how it all starts. And I'm going to start it on a little skewer stick. And here's one right here that has not got a ball on it. I'm using it for a pointer, but it is also ideal for actually sculpting your doll on. And we are actually going to come out with some of these little balls on sticks that you can buy for like $1.50 a piece, or so much for $5, so you can have a bunch of them working at one time. And they are perfect for the head. So we'll put the clay on it and make a little neck and get started. And it's easy to get the little dowel rod and ball off of it, and it actually kind of makes a hole in the top of the head, which you'll need later for the hair insertion. So that's it on this section. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is take some ProSculpt light clay. This is the one I'm going to use for this particular demonstration. I really like it. It's a wonderful clay. What I do for my finished dolls, I actually mix a little bit of Cernet in with the ProSculpt light. And I use white Cernet if you want to do a light colored fairy. So this is pretty important. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this little ball. It's an eye sizer. Okay, well, the problem with an actual eye sizer, you can't really use this particular thing unless you whack off the end, and it's hard to find them this small. These are for really small heads, and this is probably the size that we're going to make right now, because most of my students are doing 6 to 8 inch dolls. So what I do is I just, whoopsie, I stick it in there, and it really does help, and keeps your hands, by putting it on a stick, just like I told you in my other videos, keeps your hands off of the doll if you wrap a little clay around the bottom of the neck. And we're making a neck at this point. And this can be slapstick, girls and guys, any way you want to put it on, it doesn't matter. Because it's going to just be a barrier for your hands going up there and touching the face. So first thing you want to do is decide where the front of the face is going to be. So you're going to flatten out an area. Okay, and we're really going to get into all the little nuances on the face. I'm not going to use terminology that you'll find in anatomy books because, well, one, I'm not real good with words. I'm an artist. And I'm really lousy at bookkeeping, in case you've ordered from me before. And you'll know that. But I am actually going to just say what normal artists would say. The little divot under the chin or in the chin or furrow under the nose or nose wings, things like that. We're not going to get real fancy with the terminology. Okay, the first thing you want to do is just like I showed you on the photos before, you are going to want to make a skull. And the back of the neck comes way up into the skull. Like so. Just make it as high as you can for now. It's going to change, especially if you have hot hands. But we're going to try to make an oval across the front, and it's kind of an oval this direction. And if you look down on it, it's narrower in the front. We're making a lady doll. We're going to make a child and a baby later on. We're going to make sort of an oval, which is wider across the back. This is the top of the head. And I'm going to try to go fast because we've got a lot of faces to cover, but we're going to be as detailed as possible, and we're going to focus on this. First thing to do is make a line down the center. And if you were to take top of this, the bottom of this, just divide it in half. Okay. And flatten it out. And the next thing we want to do, this is a needle tool. And it's just like a pin, but it's real sturdy, and make where you think your tear ducts might be. if you were on that line. Well, I told you we want to make a younger woman. So the first thing we need to do is not work on that line. That would be the middle of her eye, and we would actually have an eye that took up that much space. But we're going to work lower. So that's the area you want. You want that much space between your eyes. We're going to make her real young looking. This is a lady, but somewhere in this location. Okay, and first thing you do is make a line through that. So that's the line you're going to base it off of to make her younger. This will be the top of her eyelid up here. And this will be the center. So, otherwise, if you had used that line, your actual top eyelid will be this farther up. We don't want that. So here's the direction we're going to go. And an eye's width between. You can see where that would be marked off. Just rough it in. It does not have to be perfect because it's going to be smashed in about 1 minute anyhow. Our main thing is figure out where the eye is going to be. The location is everything. Then take a stylus or that particular tool, but I prefer a stylus that makes a ball. I'm going to turn it around and put it dead center and make it kind of deep. Because once we've made a depression for the eye socket, we're going to lose that whole eye. Now, right just on this side of the tear duct, you want to start pushing it in. And we're going to lose the whole eye drawing. And turn it over and push it in. But we did maintain that little dot if it was deep enough. Okay, the next thing we need to do is map out where the nose is going to be. And remember, this is our line that we're basing everything off of. Okay, this is a lady, so once again, we're going to do a little roadmap thing where if this was the center line and this is the bottom, we're going to divide it in half. Pretty much. The younger you want her, the more her nose will be up a little bit. But since I'm going to give it a shot at Grace Kelly's profile especially, we want to make it a little further down. She's a little above the half mark, so I'll know that that is the bottom of her nose right there. It's not going to be out any further. And if you remember from my other tapes and what I'll show you later too, the little piece that's in between the two nose wings, it hangs down further than the nose wings. Okay, so here we go. We've got our tear ducts because that's where we started the depression, and we're going to come straight down. And this is a little bit off-centered, of course, so correct me if I'm wrong, but it's okay. It doesn't matter where you put it, just as long as you've got that level with that line. Okay, because even though we've got a center line here, everything is going to be juggled around and changed a half a dozen times, and you're going to just shoot for the center of the face, and then we'll push the clay back and make that the center of the face. Okay, these are where the nose wings are. Then we're also going to come down a little bit further, and we're going to divide, we're going to make a mouth, indication where the mouth is going to go. And I would say that's like from the bottom of the nose to the bottom of that's halfway. On children it's different. If you were doing a child, remember this particular bottom line would be up here where the nose is. Okay, I don't want to mess that up. Okay, come down with the pupils. That would be the corner of the mouth. You don't want to go out any wider than that. And the reason being, unless it's smiling, is because it's not very feminine. It thins your lips up. And if you're doing dolls, you want pouty, pretty lips. So don't go out any further. Those are just guidelines, okay? Here's the line for the center of the mouth. Okay, so we've got our guidelines, and the next thing we're going to do is we're going to get rid of a few lines that are distracting and confusing. Just a few. And I want you to know that when you do the nose bridge, there is an actual bridge of the nose and a top line. Everything is feathered up into it. So let's just go that direction. Maintain these little lines right here, as far out as the nose is going to go. Push this together. And you really don't need to add clay to this doll. perhaps on the bottom of the nose is all I ever put, just like for a little nose ball. But everything is pushed towards the center line. Right now is when you should do that. And each time I teach it at my seminars, I try a little something different, or I'll come up with a new way that they understand it better. But it's almost always the same basics of, if you're a beginner sculptor, you need to map it off. There's no way around this. Okay, the bottom, where the mouth is, make the line. All you do for that is just push up a little bit, make your line. Make a little indication underneath the bottom lip. We've just formed a bottom lip by just punching a little line. Still looks like ET, considerable amount. And what happens is I will rough in this face, and then I will go back and try to get the detail and make it look like somebody. So the next thing I do is I want to really push in on this right here. We don't want huge cheekbones, but it looks like that until we actually feathered out. One thing I told you about in an earlier tape was that when you're doing a face, you work with this part right here and get all the detail that you possibly can, and don't concern yourself about the outside, how big it is or anything. When you are actually going to make a doll from scratch, let's say you're not using a press mold, by Patricia Rose, of course, you want to do the head first. Have a jar or something just full of little sticks with heads sticking out, and just work on them every once in a while, and continue working that way. And then when you actually decide that you like the head, it's finished, then start the process of making the body that goes with the head. Okay, so I'm just going to feather this in just a little bit. You have to make a nose bridge. Can you see the side of that? Okay, just bring it in. I always keep the forehead pretty pronounced to make it young looking. Okay, and on the sides, I'm going to just take it back just a little bit. It's just a matter of take your time, don't get in a rush. Some of this I probably won't even talk, because it's hard for me to talk and sculpt at the same time. So if you're just watching what I'm doing, you'll get it. Okay, I'm going to build that little nose ball without putting clay on it, because I don't want her nose sticking out too much. And there's a depression on both sides of the nose that comes way, 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 way in. Okay, I'm going to pretend like I'm making a nose wing now. And it will be gone over a few more times, of course. And there's a little bit of fall to this area right here on both sides. Falls back. Then you're going to take, I use my thumbs for everything, and sorry about the nail polish. I try to put some polish on, look good for the tape, and he had to adjust everything and it got all messed up. So we're living with it here, guys. Okay, just a little bit back, not too much. It is harder, honest to God, to make a pretty woman and a pretty baby than it is to make an old person. If you're using like Cernet, it just has a natural tendency to make these wonderful folds. See, I just keep building, just a little at a time. I'm just pecking around on it. And then after I get where I kind of want it, then I'll go back and I'll show you where all the little nuances go, where the eye cavities and things. I keep looking at it, turning it different ways to see if it's where I want it. See, the nose is down too far. Tip it up. Push in the nose bridge a little bit more. Hollow this out. There's quite a bit of hollow right behind the nose wing. And I'm not indicating a fancy nose wing where it goes around and does all that stuff yet. On a pretty woman, we will have some of that, but we're going to keep it simple, because less information, like lines, is more beautiful. And here the chin has got a little more ball to it than what we have, so I am adding clay. But if I had just shoved it up from this point, I could have done it that way as well. If I get quiet, don't worry about it. Just follow me along if you're following it on the tape. Okay, and I'm going to thin up her face now. I have no idea what size doll this is going to be until I actually get her face 3/4 of the way finished. This is just the way it works. Okay, I'm thinning it up. I can go faster than this, but I don't think you can keep up. And then I kind of have to explain the little things that I'm doing here, but we could have had a face already. Okay, and I'm still just using this one tool, which is covered in tape, if you've noticed. Okay, I'm picking around. There's a little chin ball right here. So you want to push in, then tip up just a little bit. Not too deep now. And on children, especially, you're going to see where they have pouty lips and things. You're going to see a depression here, a bit of a line that comes down here, and this one turns this way, and this one comes around here to meet it. Just a little, see what I'm doing? Just a little bit. Okay. On the top lip. We'll give her a little bit of a smile. So we're going to turn the corners up simply by putting your thumb in and push up. I'm keeping her real simple right now. Okay, I'm gonna put nose wings in and nose holes now. I'm gonna find the right tool. I'm looking for, here it is. Okay. And if you push too much, you're gonna push your nose up. So be real careful and come back down with it if it's gone up. Take a little bit of the clay from the side and push it around into this area. And that's how our noses actually are. And this part right here in the center is further down. Making some little boogies there. Keep it simple. Feather everything away from the nose. Okay, I'm gonna play with the nose now. And I'm gonna do some little features that I didn't show in the last films. Okay, I'm gonna put a little bit of a line across the top. If you put too much of a depression there, it looks like an old man. So you don't want this to be old looking. And the deeper the lines, the more caricaturized, cartoony looking this is going to be. So I'm still building on the top of this. I haven't figured out exactly how far I want this to be in the center. But remember, it's got to come to almost a point in the dead center. Okay, I'm gonna feather this out so she doesn't look like Co-Magnon Man. And on back to the nose now. I'm going to tap in just a little bit here, a little bit here. And I am getting quieter. Pretty soon I won't be talking at all. Try to center it. See, I'm working at an angle for the camera, so I can't really see a lot of it. I'm just getting the side real good. Here we go. Okay, I'm just going to make the little furrow right under her nose. Redefine her nose. Holes and wings, they keep disappearing when you move it around. Just a little bit. If you've got hard lines on each side, a hard line is a sharp line. If this comes to a point, you have done it wrong. Okay. And when you're doing the nose holes too, to add a little touch to it, actually go the same direction that your sinuses go, and they kind of go this direction, you know. Don't make them too deep, because it changes the outside edge. There's this profile so far. Okay, now I'm going to go back and do some little treatment on the sides of the mouth. I sculpt a lot with the ball of the end of the stylus, especially when you get down to this little tiny stuff. So I'm going to put a little bitty rosebud mouth on her. And what I've done is it's kind of thick clay through here, and there's a lot of feathering out to do. But I'm going to go ahead and make a lip line. And this should not be a hard line. Everything should be padded towards the center or away from the actual line there. So we're just going to make that little line indicating you go down to the corner where I put in a little thing. See how small it needs to be? You barely touch it. You're going to have a little bit of a line in the center, but not much. Tap it down. Feather underneath. We can go back and clean up all these little things later. Just get the detail in there. You got the nose and the mouth so far. Okay, time to work on the eyes. Remember where the tear ducts were. Gotta go right here. And they come straight down by the nose wings. This keeps the nose wings from being too far out and having an ethnic appearance. Okay, we're just drawing a little line. Okay, what I do is on the eyes now, is I'll start with them wide open so you can see how that will look. And there's where they were. This would indicate that that's where the top lid is going to be too. Okay, because here's your actual pupil. So you know you can't have eyes that are like frightened to death. So that would be where your lid was going to be. The corners of the eyes get pushed back. Like so. I'm going to thin her up just a little bit. I got her heavy on one side because I've got her angled to the camera, so I can't really see what I'm doing here. You're going to thin this up just a little bit here. I'm just trying to get the face roughed in now. And then we'll go back and putz with it for a while. That's what I call sculpting. Putzing. Oh, believe me, you'll be sitting here for hours putzing, and you're going to need some pad underneath your elbows. I get it up close to the light. See what I'm pushing in here? I get it up close to the light, and you can see all these different angles that are casting little shadows, and they are so ugly. Oh my God, so this is the best way to do it. Rest it on your elbows and aim it towards the light. Okay, it's time for, I'm not going to do the bottom lid yet, time for the depression that goes in here. We're going to start with the detailing now. This is what y'all have been waiting for. Okay, the first thing you want to do is you want to put quite a bit of a depth right in this area right here. We're depressing this area. Right here. And I made her top lids. They're in there. And I'll come back with the stylist and everything and redefine those. But right now, I'm just making depressions, so I need this big paddle one. Okay, and then this, believe it or not, is considerably lower than what we've even got it. Oh my. And I'm going to take some of that clay and push it out to the sides and lose it. She's having a little facelift here. Okay. She's just a little off-centered. And heaven knows that this is going to look like Grace Kelly when I'm done, but I'm going to shoot for that profile. Okay. Face is not going to look that like that in the front. I wish I had a picture of her. My printer messed up just before this started, so can't print out a picture of old Grace. Okay, I got a hole there on the patch. So, turn her from the side. You're going to see that after all that pushing around on her, her nose bridge is still sticking out too far. So I'm going to push it in right between the top of the eyes. That's where it goes. And then feather this up. You don't want it too bulbous here, but you don't want it flat either. But pay attention and just round this out and make sure that this thing is really down in there. But there's still a high point right in the middle. Sometimes you might actually have to take out a little clay. But I think we're going to be okay. Now remember what I said. Here's the middle part. If you divide from where the pupils are, and I'm going to press those in just a little bit, by the way. From there, halfway, is right about here, and then there's the chin. And her, I said she had a real young look to her, so her nose is just a little bit above it, so we're right on the money right now. As long as you stick to these rules, you're going to come out with something that's pretty. If you use sharp lines, you're going to come up with a man that's pretty. So, okay, I'm depressing the eye cavity now. So, it's got a lot of flesh missing in those areas. Oh, not missing, but a lot of bone missing in those areas, and flesh just kind of folds into it. I can remember when I first started sculpting, I had the cheek that went right up to the eye like that. I'm like, oh my God, what was I thinking? Oh, you learn with time. It takes practice, girls and guys, to get it right. It doesn't happen overnight. Unless, of course, you buy my tape and you've seen where I made my mistakes and I had no one to show me. So it's just a matter of getting the right instructional aids and some books on anatomy. And I've got a few that we will recommend at the very end of the tape, some really good ones. And they're mostly for either portrait artists or just artists that want to understand the anatomy and bone structure and stuff. There's a lot of stuff on muscles, and you really needn't concern yourself with them that much unless you're going to do something larger. But she's starting to look like a human. She's got a little much on this one side. Okay. Here's the bones, right here. There is an actual bone right here. Down below here, it's hollow. I'm going to over-exaggerate one side so that you can see what the skull is going to actually look like. Right behind this area, this is feathered off. If you look at your eyes looking down on the top, like so. I'll probably mess that one up. Look down like so on the top of the head. You're actually going to see that the eyes are not on a flat plane. They curve around. So that means that the tear duct is far forward than the outside corner of the eye. So we want to feather this back on both sides. You know, everybody says there's like a half an eye width on the sides, and sometimes I have more space than that because I like a really wide, young-looking face. So, but, okay, feather this back. Okay, and we come up to this part right here. There is a brow bone. In men, it's really, really heavy. So, in women, it's not. So we're just going to indicate a small brow bone, and then we're going to put in, with your thumbs or your little paddle, whatever, a small indentation for the temple area. Okay, now that has to be pushed back once you've done that. Remember what I said, I'm over-exaggerating this one side so that you can see how the skull is. So, okay, here we go. And this face keeps getting smaller and smaller, the head keeps getting smaller and smaller. See, and it's not even relating to the back side of the head now, because the skull, when you actually do it, all this is going to be out of there. But see, that's why I said make the head first, then put it on a body. And when you get another tape that I have probably coming out, I'm not sure when, it'll be on proportioning and doing lady bodies and things like that, you're going to understand why you do this. And I'll show you how to match the head to a body. Okay, I'm going to make a temporary jawline. I don't really know where it is yet, but that gives me some indication of how much clay I have to move away from her face. Okay, I'll go ahead and finish off this side over here just to catch it up just a little bit, but not as deeply depressed so that the bones don't show through. Okay, look at that. I'm just taking all this clay away. And every once in a while, it's just the putzing thing that I do. You go back and you neaten it up just a little bit. And I have these tiny little brushes that I use to go in and feather everything out. Okay, if this was a fairy, that's a nice little touch. Okay, she's going to have a line. Let's say that's the bottom lid. We're playing around here. That's the bottom lid. Well, there's a little bit of a eye socket that comes right up to it, like so. But, and here's the bone on the outside. Let's feather this down a little bit. It's a little too hard. See, now that is a hard line in my mind. I have seen them so sharp that you wouldn't have believed it. Why anybody didn't see that, I don't know. But that's a hard line. But it would still make a cute fairy if you wanted to try that. But that's not my style. I like more realism. So I'm going to get rid of that pointy corner and feather just a little bit down. If you've got a little cernate in this clay, you're going to end up with smoothing like half as much because it just feathers so nice. It doesn't hold the depression as easy. It's going to kind of like bounce back just a fraction, but it smooths so much nicer. So mix a little cernate in it, and it's fabulous if you're going to use my press molds to put a cernate in it. And here I'm cleaning it up, and I've messed her chin up by doing it, so just push forward. It's amazing what you can do with this clay. I love polymer clay. I've been working in it for over 16 years now. Started with Sculpey because that's about all that was out there, Sculpey and Cernette. And the first time I picked Cernette up, I thought, oh my God, I hate this stuff. Oh, it was like marshmallow cream. I thought, they'll never keep this on the market. And look, and but they did. They're doing quite well, actually. And so I just kept working in Sculpey for a lot of years. Okay, to get a little different expression on her, this is a sad look. If you raise these areas right here, she's like worried. Okay, we don't want a worried look on her, so you want to flatten that out, take the worry off her face. Okay, I'll make this a little bit deeper. On babies, the skull is more round right here, and you're going to have an actual depression. I'm going to show you. Well, actually, I shouldn't show you because I got a baby coming up. But that's actually going to be there in a baby. You're going to see more of the skull through there. I'm going to go finish the eye now. I do it with a stylist and a needle pen, and sometimes I use that cute little rubber tool that I've got. But that's only good for finishing up real pretty little lines. Like this one could actually use that nail tool and eye detail tool. Then it's, don't know where he is. Okay. Don't make it too deep. So I'm going to take some clay out of there. How's this profile going? Okay. As I'm going through the eye, I see little places that I need to fix. There's a line that comes around the side. I get distracted. Sorry, guys. I'll come back to that eye in a minute. Right around here. Right around here. Tip up the lips a little bit more. But you try to keep them rounded through the center. And I realize everybody has a style, and sometimes I think that I really don't like my own style because I have a tendency to put too much meat right in this area. Oh my goodness. And I end up cutting it out at the very last before I fire the doll because I keep doing the same thing. So don't fall into my trap. Just don't make this too thick right in this area. Don't know why I do that. Okay. All right, now go back and do the eye. Okay, I'm going to put the pupil in with the little bitty point. I'm going to build around the pupil. And all you do is you putz with it again. You're pecking clay out. Moving it around. Remember, this has to be deeper on this side than the front where the actual tear duct, which is right there, comes down. And this is deep. See how deep that's gotten? And this is thicker from this point to this point. And the corners of the eye, they all come to a point. I got too much flesh there. This is the highest point that sticks forward, but this is still more forward than this. Just got a few rules to follow, and if you do the same thing every time, you're going to come up with something that looks human. And that's pretty, actually. Okay, I'm going to make the whites of the eyes a little deeper. This is what they do in classical sculpture. They have a depression for the pupil. And I'm going to tip this up a little bit. And I've got to come bring the eyelid where the socket is in a little further. I'm going to make the other one match, and then I'm going to go back and I'm going to do a Grace Kelly kind of thing. So just get them to where they're the same. And I'm pecking around again. If somebody's got a good picture of Grace Kelly, send it to me. Flatten that out, redefine the pupil each time because I keep losing it, make sure the corners are down. We're going to try to do two more heads in this video, a young girl and hopefully a toddler, or I'm going to start out trying a baby, but sometimes they change a little older. Remember, if you've got your lines right, then you can be right on the money with the age group that you're looking for. I lost my tool. There it is. Don't be afraid to put a line in there like that. You can always smooth it out later. This is just to see if you've got it in the right location. Yeah, I use these tiny little paint brushes after I'm all done. And I'll tell you what else I do. I smooth the head completely before I actually put it on the body. I have finished heads because when you are actually cleaning up the piece, when it comes down to that point where you're cleaning it and getting scraping off the lumps and dirt and everything else, you do not want to come in with a sharp knife on a face like this and think that you're not going to peck it or mess it up. And it's just, and as small as some of them are, this is a large face. It's probably going to be 9 to 10 inch doll when I'm finished. Most of them, the faces are the size of my finger, so you can see where you get a long one. It's tiny, so you don't want to go back and clean up areas on it where you could have cleaned it up to begin with just smoothing it out with paint brushes and that kind of thing. So that is sort of her. It's not perfect, but I'm going to call that good enough, and then I'm going to start my Grace Kelly thing after I study her for a few minutes. In order to get an accurate, detailed version of a profile, if you have a picture that you want to go by, just put the head close to your face, hold the picture further back so that when they line up, the profiles line up, you know how far off or how far to the right that you've got it. So that's it. You saw the profile of Grace, and I'm going to show you the last little nuances and things to do for finishing her up. Okay, I do it with a filbert. I think it's a 10-0 little paintbrush. It's got a tiny little rounded edge, and it's kind of worn down already, but it's working fine. And I actually sell these, but you can get them in any paint store, art supply paint store. Okay, so you want to take this and push in. You're going to finish off all your detailing with this thing. Honest to gosh. And I'm going to make it a little bit deeper right in here. I'm going to push this in just a little bit here. Feather that in. Everything gets feathered with this thing. I've got some bigger brushes too for the bigger areas, but right around the features you need to use this thing. If you've ever looked at a a nose straight on. There's a deep area right in here. You'll see it on each side. And then it's like a high ridge right in this section. See where I've got my brush? And you can see a little high ridge. I hope you're able to see it. And look what I just did. But it can work out. Okay, and the same thing for the front of the nose here. You're going to push more towards that and pull away from the sides and round those edges up. I'm going to go back with my nail tool now and do a real clean little line. That's what I have that little nail tool thing designed for, those really nice little lines. And I'll show you in a minute. Okay, and you're going to feather this around. Just a little, you barely touch this. Barely touch this. It changes everything. Like on the sides, tuck it in out there. Just get rid of some of this. Push it up. And this is just regular Pro Sculpt, like clay, girls and boys. I haven't got any Sternet in this. With Sternet, oh my gosh, it just smooths in a heartbeat. Okay, I'm going to do a little bit on the top lip there. See, she's got a little bit of a divot in the center that hangs down. Don't know if you can see that. I'm assuming you can, because I remember the last tape we made. It was pretty detailed. Feather to the side. This comes down like so. You can make any kind of bottom lip you want, but I like a real full bottom lip. Wish I had one of my own. My daughter has a pretty mouth. Okay, and then round out the little edges here. See, it is a chin ball, and so that is an actual muscle, and it is a depression, just a tiny one on each side of it. Just a tiny little thing. I haven't got it really rounded up good, but you can work at them and get it. And all this, you know, I tapped in here, and that left a little bit of a hard line. I mean, you probably can't even see it, but I can see it from where I am. And it just drives me crazy, all these little hard lines. Okay, and then feather out, come back, and try to hold it up. You don't want the metal part of the brush to do what it just did on this. You just hold it right up into the piece. Feather it up, and here's the temple area. Pull it back some. Okay. My thumb is the best thing for the big areas. That and this other paintbrush I have. Okay. Feather, feather, feather. Oops. Making a little debris, but I'll go back and pick it out. And see, I'm saving right there all those little areas. That's my tool that's going to come back and get those and bring out the detail. That's a hard line there. Hard line there, but I'm working them out. Just get in there with this little brush on these places on the near the features. Okay, now I'm going to go back and catch some more detail with my nail tool. It takes the slightest touch. This thing just cleans up the line all the way around it. Stuff it in the nose. Oops, a little bit of, less of a touch. I don't know what this tool does, but it just works so wonderfully. And then I'm going to go and regain the detail on the top lid. Getting a little debris, so just tap it to the back, get rid of it. It's the touch and the tool, folks. And I'm seeing I've got too much clay there because this actually goes in further. So I'm going to try to get rid of it. This is not a takeout tool, it's a detail tool. So we got to go back and feather that down in there.
She's cute. She looks like a little pin-up girl. Gee. If I had a good picture of Grace from the front, it probably wouldn't look like this, but she has her profile. And you're going to see like the little cheekbone there. I don't want it too wide, so I'm going to keep thinning until, if you're looking straight at it now, the camera's looking straight at her, she has a little bit of a round turn here, but you're not going to see a lump. So you want to make sure that the lump is on the front part and you're pushing the clay back towards the back on the sides. See, I thin her up, she looks a little more classy. I still got little places like this. You can see where it's too thick right there, and it's just right on this one side. And my nail tool. Get back in there. You really kind of need a steady hand. So if you're propping your elbows up, like I told you, you're okay. Now see, this has gone up too far. I've done it quite by accident. It's just so tiny, you know. So I'm going to have to get rid of the clay there. And I want to make a depression where it goes into the corner. And a little bit of a line comes across here. And then we're going to take our little brush, tap it in so it looks more realistic. See, little tiny things like that. See where I just did? Just tapped in. Same thing for this side. Tear duct comes down just a little bit. This part right here is rounded out. And it's like it sloops down and then it comes back up into, and then it goes down again in the tear duct, and that's how that one goes. Okay, well basically on this head, all I have to do is make that side of the face match this side of the face. And a tiny bit of cleanup, and we have a head. If you want to put a brow line on it, it's quite simple. You know, so that you know where and you can test where the brow is supposed to be. And then when you go to paint it, if you've indicated a brow line, then you won't have any problem actually finding that ridge and just paint right on top of it. So there's where the paint goes. Whoops, there's where the paint goes. Okay, basically this part of her face is done. I just did a little something right there. I can see some little lumpies. Now I'll tell you how you really see lumpies. Turn her upside down. Oh my gosh. There's all kinds of places the way the shadows cast in, and you're going to have to go back and clean it up and make sure you do this every single time, because schlocky work gets low prices if you're trying to sell it. Strive for perfection, young ladies and gentlemen, because that is what your customer wants. This is going to be a young girl. I'm not sure the age yet, but as I said, we're going to buzz through this one because we've got another head to do at least. I hope to get four, but there's no way. We're running out of tape. So, I'm going to go at the speed of light like I do to do this, and you can rewind it a gazillion times and watch what I do. That way you'll get it, but I won't be talking a whole lot in it. Remember what I said, basics are X marks the spot. You get that going. This is going to be young girl, so I'm going to put her eyes just a little bit lower than my half mark, and then I'm going to divide it from that part into three equal places. So the nose is about here, up or down, doesn't matter. You know, you'll figure it out after you get it on there. But, and her eyes are going to be on this line. Okay, I'm going to make the tear ducts so I know how far down to come with the size of the nose wings. Then I'm going to make a depression that is actually going to be the pupil. And remember what I said, it has to go in pretty deep because you're going to push down on it and you're going to lose it if you don't. I'm just going to go through this real quick. Rewind the tape if you missed something. Okay, I'm going to build it up in the center where the nose ridge is. Maybe a little further down here. Push in on the sides. Tip up on the nose. The nose. Mouth. Just push it in just a little bit. Tip up. Make a little line for the chin ball. Depression on each side here. Take the kneaded clay away from the doll's face. We're going to put back some little depressions on each side. Those are perhaps a little too big. It's all right. Bring the clay around that. Little furrow in the middle. We need a little more clay for her nose. It's in there. You just want to rework it. If you add clay, just remember, every time you add clay, you're adding air to it. So it's better to try to move what you have around and build on it as opposed to patching in a piece and having to stitch it in. It takes longer anyhow. Okay. Now I'm trying to get to a point where I can put some little nose wings in there so I can figure out what I want to do with her. The eyes, there's your tear duct still. That's the center of the eye, the pupil. I'm going to make them like so. Kind of almond shape to start with. And then I'll smash him in a little bit more and make an eyelid. High on the top, right about from here to here. It's higher. Goes down to a corner. Push in on the sides. Use the size of your thumbs. They're your best spreading, thinning out, feathering tool that you have. Okay, temple area, smash it in just a little bit above the brow area and on the sides. Leave lots of fingerprints on it because that's just what you do. And we're getting there. She doesn't look too terribly ugly. Okay. Tap it in a little bit. Round out the little chin ball a little bit more. Top lip up just a little bit. And the clay is supposed to be straight line across here until you get your detailing in, and lift up on the paddle and down on it this way and round it up. No hard lines, folks. Try to eliminate that. Hard lines are sharp edges, and there are no sharp edges on your face. I'm sure if you look in your mirror, you'll agree with me. See it from the side, her nose is tipped down too far, so let's tip it up. It's looking more like a child. Okay, yeah, I need some, this one. Hollow just below her eye for the skull, depression where the eye socket is. We're going to take a lot of clay away from this area right here. This is where most people make their mistake. You really push it in there. But you don't want it too deep, because if you tip up on it like this, you're going to end up with a sad expression. And lots of putzing around. Okay. Nose wings. Down to the refining already on this, and the smoothing out is where you get all those wonderful little curves and things. Okay, tap it in just a little bit more. Don't worry about every little thing that's not quite lined up, because you're going to change it around probably 10 more times before you're finished with it. I'm never happy with the first time I sculpt it. You know what I do? I let it sit around for about, honest to God, a week, and then I finish them. I counted it just a little while ago. I've got a chain hanging from my ceiling from one side of the studio to the other, and I have 15 figures hanging on it. Oh my God. I'm thinking, am I ever going to finish those? And I do. I just go, the mood, you know, when the mood hits you, you know, you see one like, oh, I know what she's going to be. And there she just evolves. So if you've got a lot of options and you've got a little cernit mixed with your stuff, it's not going to crack hanging around, you know. Well, actually, Perisculpt doesn't do it either, but some of the other clays have a tendency to crack the longer they hang around. So. And then I'm going to put that little tiny nuance right there, coming down across her face. Tap it back up in there. And I lost her pupils, but you know, that's easy to regain. Okay. Nose wings. I'm going to go tap in on the side. Tap in on the side. That's obviously too much. So we will feather out. There's a lot of little things you can do with the nose. You know, I don't know whether some people have a preference about which way those nose holes go, but I like mine kind of angled this way. I was looking at Grace Kelly's. Hers are angled funny. They're kind of pretty, though. And tap in here. Pull a little clay out. Just rearrange it. I'm looking at her, and I finally got a look at her from the front. I'm doing her from sideways. She's got too much brow line, and it's kind of haunty looking, so I'm going to take that away simply by feathering this back. And what it does, it opens up her eyes a little bit more. She looks younger. She's got a slash in the middle of the forehead that needs to go. And give her little cute little cheekbones. And I'm making her resemble the one I previously did, the older lady, but she's just a younger version of that. Okay, now I'm down to where all I need to do is a couple little pecks on it and some brush work. Honest to God, the brush is everything. Let's go back and put the irises in the pupils in. Tap around sides. You know, of course you're going to have to go back and refine it 20 times more after you've finished it. But you, when you paint it, make sure you put a little darker, cast a shadow. Let's say you have blue eyes. You want to make sure there's darker blue at the top here so she doesn't have a real scared look if the color's all the way around the same. It's just really weird. So, and you want to get those down in there some. You don't want them to stick out. the irises in the pupil. Remember what I said, the tear duct comes down, this part goes around and goes right into it, bottom lid. So you want to go right across that iris and push down. And I'm seeing I've got too much clay right in this area. This is one of the major problems people do. They do not get it deep enough right there. So look for little things like that. And I've got her a little crooked, but you get the drift. And you know, it takes a while to feather things out and smooth it up. Okay, just touch up her nose one more time because it's kind of wild looking. Around the nose holes. It's a little hard. Hard meaning the line's too deep. So now I'm down to the brushing. Remember what I said, little tiny brushes for little tiny areas, the big brushes, and I have one that's right here for the wider areas, like so. At the last of it all, before your doll is fired, do yourself a favor, spend a little time, if the doll's hanging from the ceiling, and get rid of the fingerprints. Don't see if you, I've got nail polish all over it and fingernail prints all over it. But you can pick the nail polish out and then go back and get the fingerprints out before you fire her. Otherwise, you will have to sand her, which I'm sure you're going to do anyhow if you're, you know, trying to do a really good doll. But it takes just minutes to get the fingerprints off and pulls the whole thing together. She looks like Frankenstein, her forehead's so big. Baby, just thin her up a bit there. And cut back on the sides. That's what I'm doing, push it to the back. Don't worry about what's out the back end. You're gonna trim it off because you don't need it. We'll actually do a jawline on this one. Okay, yeah, we're gonna get three in this film, I do believe. It's gonna be a baby, the next one. I don't know how young, but it'll be a small child. And this little girl is looking probably, oh, I don't know, 10, 12. If the nose, I don't like big noses, bulbous noses. It's not a real feminine thing. It's cute as for a baby, but it's not really pretty for a lady or a start of a young girl. So I take all I can off the end of the nose. We thought we were going to have to add some to the nose, and we didn't have to do that. There's plenty of clay there now. And see, I've messed her nose up a dozen times already, and you can just pull it right back if you know where to go with it. Tip it up, feather it out. It's a little better. Okay. We're going to do a tiny bit of detailing on the lips. And then we'll start with the brush. Just a little bit. These areas, you don't want them sticking out too far now. I do a lot with a stylus, I just realized. Okay, brush. See if the eyelid hangs down too much, push it up with the brush, feather it back. Lots of cleanup in there. I'm taking a little longer than I normally do because I'm having to explain it, and it's hard to think and talk and work at the same time. I'm just oblivious when I do this. I just like sit there and do it. God, I don't even think about it. I've been doing it so long. Yep, it takes you a bunch of practice. See, I keep changing around, and eventually I'm going to come up with a look that I just go for and do all the detailing completely, because that's the one I wanted. Keep changing around. make your pupils up a little higher. Try that look. This is wrong. Everybody does this. This is another thing. Eyes are tough. Where you've got a line coming down here and a line coming down here, that is a big no-no. What you do is you define that bottom part first, then the top part, push it back into there, get rid of it. Nice little tool. And feather it down into it. You can just push it back. Your brush will take care of the rest of it. I don't like her profile, so I'm going to feather it some more, round her little nose up. It's getting better. I think you can see it, can you? Yeah, profile. Okay. The mouth kind of bothers me, so it's like somebody smacked her and she flattened her lips. So what we do is we stick our little brush in, feather up, push down, feather towards the sides. Remember what I said, that fatal mistake I keep making right there? I have too much right in that area on all of my dolls. And I think that's how people recognized my work all these years, until I realized what I was doing wrong. I'm saving you a lot of aggravation. Pay attention to that part. Okay. Yeah, this video started out kind of slow. I just was a little nervous, but hey, I'm into it now. Yeah, the young man that's filming this says, it's like listening to you at your kitchen table. It's like folksy. So, I'm going to say she's pushing, being done. Let's just tap in, flip up just a little bit, feather, give her a little smile. Oh, I know what I was going to do. Put some ears on her. How about some ears? Didn't do my last doll, but there's a little divot right here, but you don't want to make it too hard. Never make it deep. Never make it an actual line on a small child. The only one you want to put those lines are on are men. That's a masculine feature. So, how about a dimple? Duh. How about another dimple? I just love doing this. This is so fun. I don't know what else I could do that would make me as happy and make a good living, let me tell you. Okay, I'm pushing in a little bit here, bring out a little more detail. See, everything's kind of finished up with the brush. And not real happy with his eyes, but keep pushing in on them. At some point, you will be satisfied. Okay, let's go to this side over here, since it's the only one I can see. And we're going to go and put an ear on her. So if this were correct, which is not exactly right, get rid of that. And if you took from the front of the head to the back of the head, and this was on my other two videos, make a straight line, it's like about half. You have to, before you can finish your jawline, you have to have an ear in there. So if you were going to take a line and come across to the top of the ear, it would be somewhere in the eye area. And this would be like at the bottom of the nose or top of the mouth in that area. And the ear is on an angle. It was like at least 15 degrees or more. And so we're just going to make a little C that indicates the top right there at that angle and the bottom. So I'm going to grab some clay from the back side. Here we do add on. And stick it on there. I'm going to try to find those little lines that I just made because the clay is a little much. Okay. And you want to have a lot more clay at the top of it than you do at the bottom. So just shove it up there. Okay. And then feather it in on the side of the face. But don't push too hard because you're going to change the shape of the outside of the face. Okay. And our temple area is going to come in. If you can see that from the front. Okay, now for the jawline. Right behind the ear, the clay starts disappearing right here. what's clay, not clay, the skull. There's no skull there. That's the skull's way back up here. And you can just take this off with a tool or whatever. I normally don't have fingernails, so this is a real treat. I grew them out specifically for these videos I'm making, which I really regret it now because I spend most of my time cleaning up the nail marks. So if you're practical about the whole thing, you should cut your fingernails off. Okay, got the clay out of the way. You come down a smidge. There is no definite line for this. And you want to take it and just roll it around to the front where the chin is. Then take away the clay because that is the neck. And let me go real quick and do this side. Sometimes you can just look underneath and see where it's kind of going to be. So, yeah. Because I want to give you a finished face with little ears on it. See, I don't even look at it anymore. Just stick it on there and make it go. I don't measure it off. That's what I'm saying. Sometimes I should. Because you're never so good that you don't make boo-boos, let me tell you. Oh, I'm not perfect. Okay, she's got ears on her. And you're going to look for, if you have to, stick a toothpick out here, stick a toothpick here, and one on this side, and then just look for a parallel line across them so that you can know that your ears are in the same location. Or look underneath like this part right here and make sure that your ears are in the same location with the jawline. And see, I've got flesh to remove here. I don't know if you can see this on the camera or not, but I took out a bunch of flesh here and there's still more to be removed at this point, so we will fix her later. Okay, but that's her. Oh, how about just a little more detail on the ear? Can't remember everything, guys. I'm concentrating on that baby. Babies are tougher than you think. My next video will be the baby in full. You know, write down little fat folds on the legs and everything else, and we're going to make two videos this week. So that's all I'm doing. Mm-hmm. Okay, just make a big depression here. There's three little places on the ear. Just make three to start with. Don't worry about connecting the dots yet. Okay, this one has a little ridge over top of it, like so. And it doesn't go very deep. And it curves around, like so. And goes all the way down into there, but it stops before it gets there, so you have to have a place for your pierced earring to go. See, that's where it goes. Okay, and then I'm going to do a little detailing on the back side here, get rid of some of this clay. This is a little fat. You're going to thin it up, of course, but I don't want to mess it up too much just yet. There is a section right here that comes all the way around, catches up with this hole. And this is the really big one. Here, like, give it an eardrum there. See? Okay, and then there's a little thingy in the center that crosses over the top of this. That little flap. Now this is going to have to be buried just a little bit underneath of that. I know this seems complex, but study ears. Gosh, I used to hate them. Oh, gosh. Fingers, toes, ears, all the hard stuff that used to be hard. It's a treat now. Faces are dessert. Everything else is still a pleasure to sculpt, but I think the hardest thing is hands. Hands are a bear. Yeah, I'm not real happy with those. But that's an ear, essentially. This can be thinned up some. And I think we're ready to move on to the baby. This is the baby that I've chosen. Very little in the way of upper eyelids and no teeth showing. Cute little ears, nice shape. So that's what I'm going to shoot for. And I'm going to blow through this as fast as I can because we're running out of tape and I want to try to show you everything I can. So I'm on with it here. Okay, once again, ladies and gentlemen, remember what I said. On a baby, everything has to go at the bottom. There's an air bubble in this thing. Goodness sakes. Everything has to go on the bottom, and I want it to really be in the bottom. So I'm going to make it down here. And I'm going to do it the way I do it. And it's a whole lot faster than what I've been showing you. So just keep up with me. You divide it into three equal parts once you get the eye. Remember that. The little nose, little tiny nose. Push it up. Remember, it's going to be high. Little mouth. Tip it up. Little chin ball. Little fat jaws. You can see it already looks like a baby. You get your basics right to start with. Everything else falls in place after that. Just a little formula. See, even from the side, it's starting to look like a baby. Okay, let's see. Get a little more detail on the mouth here. Tiny little mouth. I'll pretend the nose holes because we haven't cleaned them up yet. Need to move our clay around a little bit more. You can make these areas kind of deep right here because there's a whole lot more fat on that little face. They are so cute. I only had one, that was enough. I decided I wanted to sculpt instead. Raise kids. So ye who have a lot of children, oh, my heart goes out to you. My daughter's gonna have 5 soon. Okay. And I do have a tendency to sculpt what my daughter looked like when she was small. You will. You'll sculpt your family members and stuff like that. Okay, now, remember I said most of this is just feathering, and if you pick up the right tools, you can actually... the right tools. You can actually put the detail in this early on. See? Little mouth. Bring the little nose holes a little bit more. Even them out. See, I've got everything kind of crooked, but this just is pecking around and taking time to finish it off. But you can see I've got it already. How on the big eyes. Okay, here comes an eye. Here comes another one. Remember what I said, the eyes are basically the same size as what you're born with, is what you end up having as adults, too. Your eyes don't grow. Your ears and your nose continue to grow until you die. Did you know that? Oh my God, that's why you see these little old men in these nursing homes with these humongous lobes on their ears and these noses that just never go, never stop growing. It's like, oh my gosh. We have a lot to look forward to in our old age, don't we? I'm going to feather this back, bring in his temple area. I think it's a little boy baby. I'm not real sure. Doesn't look real feminine. Well, we can make her feminine by putting girl hair on her and longer eyelashes and pinker lips. And that's basically all there is to it. Okay, we got a baby. Looks better from the side. I think take it in a little bit more. And take it up. But see how easy it is once you have your formula, which is the X in the middle. You know where the line comes across and where you want the three sections to be equally divided on the bottom line. So knowing that you're going to put your eye line below the half mark on a baby assures you of coming out with a baby face in just a matter of no time at all. This is not an especially cute one, but give me a few minutes and at the very end of this tape I will finish it off and you'll see what it looks like. Just remember, everything's done at the end with this little bitty brush. Just feather, 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 and round everything up. Okay, so this is pretty much the finished baby, and what I'm doing now is some fine detail brush work, and I deepened the area right in here, and the little baby picture that I'm using doesn't have much of an eyelid, so I just give it an overhang like that, and there's an indication of an eyelid underneath there. Okay, but we want to take it back to the side just a little, and do a little depression on each side right here. I like this little three-quarter view, it's cute. So basically all there is to do on this one now is just feather it out. I took quite a bit of tissue out right there, so I was able to put the little dip in and smile. I had to add a little more, just a little teeny bit on the chin ball because it wasn't quite round enough. And now just feather out the nose. And I'm not going to mess with this too much more because I just don't think I'm going to be able to improve it a whole lot more because it kind of looks like a picture. What I thought I might do for those of you that want to really get serious about this detailed faces tape is take the three babies, the three dolls that I sculpted on this, and actually offer them all three together in one press mold. So if you get the video, you'll want to get the little press mold, which will probably sell on eBay and on my website, that you can double check your work along with what it really looks like. So be like your guide. Let's talk about firing first. Before you sand it or before you actually scrape it, you want to fire it lightly, and lightly means partially cooked. I've been quoted as saying different times, but I've been experimenting, and the best way to do it is at 230 degrees for approximately 9 minutes. And what you do is, here's the little two faces, the lady, the child, and the baby right here. What you do is you start with a cool oven and you want to turn it on to 230. Put your piece in the oven on a little piece of glass. This is the glass that I use, about this size, larger if it's a larger piece, and set your timer for approximately 9 minutes. It'll take about 5 minutes for the oven to get up to 230 degrees, and then approximately 4 minutes of it is the actual firing time at the 230 temperature. So as soon as the timer goes off, and I live with a timer on my belt, you want to turn the oven completely off and then open the door of the oven and just let it cool down naturally in the oven. Don't take it out, let it cool down. So, and then you want to start scraping it after it's cooled. And an X-Acto blade is just fine. It has it's pretty rigid. You don't want to have one of those little scalpels that are only about $1 a piece, because what they do is they have flex in the blade, and they will nick it if you aren't real careful. So I've got a new blade in this one, and it's at the 230 degree temperature. You can actually sand it a lot easier because it's still not real hard. The final firing on these pieces is going to be at 275, and you want to put that, let's say your doll is a 6-7 inch doll, you're going to fire it for about 20 minutes. Now if you have a convection oven, oh my gosh, you've got it all, girls and guys. It keeps the temperature circulating in there evenly throughout the whole piece, and you don't burn fingers. If you're actually firing a doll that has little fingers on it and everything, just watch it like a hawk. I generally don't do the hands
until the piece has been fired this first stage. And then I go back and do the hands, put them on and fire them with the finished 275 temperature. So, and all you do is you just sit here for, well, faces are not too bad. You just stay in the bigger areas with the bigger blades. Like I told you prior to this firing, when you are sanding or smoothing out with little tiny brushes, get all the detail sanded and smoothed out with a brush. Well, not sanded, but smoothed out with a brush before you fire it. That way you don't have to put your blade in on the interior of any of this. The only thing I would advise is perhaps if the eyelids might be a little too thick or something, you could take it and just barely do this. But make sure it's already finished before you fire it. And then just stay in the open areas with the bigger blades. Okay, and the reason I cut these two little heads down, look half like this, it's not what you would do if you were going to make a doll, of course. You'd want to leave it on the stick like this and completely finish it up. And then you'd put it on your doll body once you've figured out what your proportion sizes are and everything for the actual size of the doll. This one I'm going to be making another video of a full bodied doll. It's going to be a baby, and this is going to be the head for the next video that I do, which will be this week. Anyhow, and these now, we're actually going to make you a press mold so that you can see, and this face will actually be in the press mold too, the baby one will, but for right now it's going to be on a body. Anyhow, these two little faces right here are cut off like this because this is how you get ready for a press mold. Now I'm going to flatten this out more. You can see where the ball was on that, the little stick that had the ball on it right here, this thing. And it just stabilizes it when you use these little tools so it doesn't move around so much. On a regular, just the pole itself, it has a tendency to move up and down, so that's why you put those on there. So if you're making press molds so that you can get a really good likeness again and again and again, this is how you do it. You cut them off like this and you fire them flat, and that's it for this stage. We're going to go to the painting section of this video, and I've got a little bit of acetone in a little cap. And first thing I want to do is clean my brushes from the last time. I just leave them. You don't have to clean these brushes very often. And I leave the paints in a little tray like this. It's a palette, basically, with the different colors, and I can mix it in between. And they never dry out as long as you have them on glass and certain kinds of plastic. So it's Genesis Heat Set paints. And you can get them from their website, or there's a multitude of places. I do not sell them and don't intend to. So now clean your brushes first from the last time. Acetone is what I clean my brushes with. And also you can take a little acetone and from where you scraped the doll's face, you're going to see some little white marks and everything else. You can take some clean acetone, not this of course, and go over the whole thing lightly. I've put some clean acetone and a little cap, and this is how you do it. You lightly go over it. I take some of it off and then just lightly go over it. You don't want to soak the piece. And I hope you're able to see that it's eliminating all the white marks on this doll's face. And if you have to go over it again for any reason, once again, it's a light thing, because what it does is it eats into the surface of the clay. Now, I've already fired this doll head the second time, so she's fired at 275. For approximately 15 minutes, because it's a thin piece, and I've gotten it ready for the press mold. So, and there's a little boo-boo, but that doesn't matter on the press mold. It won't even go down that far on it. And I'm going to have a film later on tricks of the trade and this year, and I will actually show you how to make your own press molds, and if you want to do a full body press mold. We might even have a film for that coming out later. But right now, we're just doing a face press molds that I'm going to show you how to do in the next film. Okay, so you've got her cleaned up lightly. Same thing for the second one. You can see little rough spots on it. Okay, we're going to go ahead and start painting her. And what I do first is I put a very light coat of the glazing medium on it. And I have it over here. And I treat it like you do china paint, because I've been in porcelain for so long. And you basically, let's see, I don't want to put anything there. I was just testing it to make sure there wasn't anything else on the brush. Light coat, and it's going to soak into the actual doll's flesh, I'm going to call it now. It's not clay anymore. It's a person. Okay. Just put a little bit on it in the areas I'm going to need. There's a piece of glitter. Oh, dear. It's everywhere. Now, this glazing medium, if you don't get all the white off of it, don't worry about it, because when it's fired and if you put the glazing medium over the whole thing, it will indeed eliminate the white when you fire it. So, just a little bit. And then I kind of wipe it down. Okay. And I want to start with the color of my eye, which will be a lighter blue. I generally don't paint the whites of the eyes, especially with this real light clay that we've got now, because the human eye is not as white as you think it is. And all of you girls and guys out there that are painting the whites of the eyes, you might want to reconsider that, because it doesn't look real natural if you're painting it with white. If you're going to paint it with a real soft flesh color or off-white. Okay, got the color in there first. Then sometimes I don't even bother to use black anymore. I said it probably on another one that I don't use black. Well, I still don't. I probably put a dark purple. It seems like it's even darker than black sometimes. And the dead center of the iris. It's really kind of tricky. And usually I do this under 400 with my 400 glasses on that I got from Walmart. And then I have my magnifier light, which is 400, because you really can't be too careful. See, I've got a little spot right there that's out of whack already. So you can pick it up sometimes with this little tool right here, and your nail tool, your detail nail tool, is a wipeout tool as well. You can pick up the paint and remove it. So give that a try. And I want to put, remember when I said I want a darker color over the top of the eye, so that we can make it look like she's not so scared. So we want to put a little bit of darker blue on the very top of that, and outline it with just a little bit of darker blue. And it's still a pretty color. And at the end of all this, you could actually, if you're really careful, put some embossing powders, like a little bit of blue, anything. And I would say after it's all, Genesis paints are all fired and everything's on there, then I would go back and do the little embossing thing to make it look, have some serious punch. And take your heat gun. You use a heat gun or an embossing gun. And if you're going to use an embossing gun, it gets really, really hot, so be real careful. You don't want to do that for very long, because they bubble up too much. So I put a little bit of, let me clean out my brush just a little bit more, because I don't want to put purple on her eyelids necessarily. A little bit wouldn't hurt. A color over top if you're going to make a like some eyeshadow or whatever. But you just want to put a tiny, tiny bit of pinks. I put less color on them now than I used to. Because of this really pretty light clay,
It just seems to take less for some strange reason. It's just more delicate. ProSculpt. I like ProSculpt. And I mix it with a little white Cernet sometimes. And put a little bit underneath here, just a little bit. A little bit in the nose holes. And this is, the colors that I use are actually on my website. So you don't write me about it. Because trust me, they're on there. And blend it in.
Alright, and after you've got these little pink areas in there, you want to take a dry brush, and isn't this a beauty? It's got sprayed out from your edge. You just feather it in so it looks more natural. So I don't want to put a lot into this, but you do have to do the dry brushing thing. Boy, I used to put a lot of paint on these faces. This is nothing compared to it. I'm going to take a little bit of, it's a darker flesh, and just outline this just a little bit deeper to accentuate it. Oops, I'm going to come around here and do this. And I don't need to take a dry brush to that. Because it's just real faint anyhow. It doesn't need to feather it out. I need to keep the color in the groove there. And I'm going to take some what would be burnt umber color. And try to get it on your brush to where it just rolls to a point. And then this is heavy color, so you'd be real careful. When it's real thick on the brush, when you first put it on, put it in the big areas you need to saturate with color. And then after it thins up a little bit on the brush, then go back and get the delicate little areas like so. And I'm not going to give her little pointy corners of her eyes or anything just yet. Oops. It's real tricky. You just got to be real careful. I'm going to put it in there. Just a little tiny bit. And if I don't like it, remember I can take it out with the wipeout tool, which is also the nail tool. I'm going to do one side of her face because we have a limited amount of time. I'm going to try to get everything in there. So I'm going to go back and work on just this one half of the face here. And then at the end of this film, I'm sure we'll see all of it completely done. On the eyebrow, you want to start with a lighter, darker tan or beige and kind of pencil it in. Don't go too close to the center. That's a real sign of an amateur, but you don't know where eyebrows go. You don't want a Brooke Shield kind of look there. You just have to tweeze it out then. Okay, and once again the little pickup tool, the one that you have is going to work just for this too. You want to take a light, very light touch and do a straight line down, wipe it off, and you're making brows and go this direction. That is how the brow grows. And if you want it a little darker, you can add a little more color, just a little stroke at a time. But not much. I'm going to be happy with that. This could be a little darker too. And then come around. And light lashes. Don't use heavy lashes. If you're using dark colors for lashes, it's going to look like a Vegas showgirl. If that's not your intention, you might want to try to use a soft beige. Okay, I could use a little darker color in the nose holes.
since I've got it on the brush already. Yeah. You want to take the pink and lightly go around the corners of the nose wings, just a little bit. And this is one of those things where you use the dry brush, once again, to feather it in. You don't want a lot of color on her. And up across the top of the nose, just a little bit. I'm hoping you're able to see this, but it's just a faint bit of color. You want to come down, put a little more pink. I mean, it's got a little beige and pink mixed together here, that taupe and pink that I mixed together, but it's really diluted with the medium, the glazing medium. Okay. And remember, always feather it out. What I'm finding for the blush on the cheeks to do is load up a brush of the cheek color and then wipe it all down till the brush is completely dry and let the brush sit about an hour. And then when you go back and you put it on the actual cheek, it blends in really, really nice. It's like a dry brush effect, but it comes out more even. If you do it with the glazing medium or just the color itself right on the clay, it's going to end up being blotchy. So try that little trick with the blush where you actually let it load up a brush, you know, a real kind of a big brush that you can feather around with, and let it dry for a while after you've totally got all you could out of it, and then it's still got some debris in it, and that's the best way to do it. Comes out looking really, really natural. Okay, we're going to do the parting of her lips. I'm going to put a little red. I'm hoping it's the right color. It's going to be pretty dark, but we want a deep crevice right through there. There we go. And don't take it all the way out to the edges. I kind of had a slip there. Nobody's perfect here. You can feather it out. Put a little bit right at the top. We're going to work all this in. Her lips are not going to be that dark, trust me on this one. Okay. Clean my brush out because it's just too dark. I'm going to take a little bit of the pink. And I'm going to just dab it on there, and then I'll feather these two together. The pink by itself is too bright. And the dark red, reddish brown color is too dark. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that little bit of brown that I have up there, a little bit more here, and I'm going to outline her lips. See, I pull a little bit from the side and drag it into the corner. I got a little pink in there, but hey, there's the brown. Okay. And you don't want a sharp peak. You want to feather the two together. Feather out the pink. Pull the pink down into it from the top lip. Remember, when you're painting, you want to make sure the top lip is a little darker than the bottom lip. That's the way the light hits our face anyhow. The bottom lip catches light from above, and so this is always, the top lip is always going to be in the shadows, more or less. Oopsie, I got it on there. Whoop. Got carried away there. You don't want it up there now, do we? Yeah, I'll come back and get that later. Let's go on with this. And the dark color, bring it out of the corners. Down into the top, the bottom lip rather. But see, it's all a matter of feathering. It's just like you feather the piece when you're smoothing it out. Everything should be soft on that face. The entire body, if you want a sensual female, you know. Okay, blot it just a little bit. And I think I could probably use a little bit darker on the bottom, but not by much. So we've got little bit, tiny thin line, and then we'll drag it up into it. Yeah. So if you are one of those girls like I am that has to have lip liner on all the time to make your lips look a little fatter, you should have no problem with this technique. Okay, and then there is a separation between the two. If you have a little bit of paint on there, it's a little bit darker, one shade down. You put it in the center. That's not even going to show. Okay. And there is not much more to this doll if you want a beautiful fairy doll. So I'm going to finish it off camera, and at the very end of this tape, you'll see it. It'll probably be on the cover of the tape too. So that's pretty much it, girls and guys. Just have a light touch and keep it clean. See you next tape.